5 seconds remaining.
Hello, and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to an international 4 Chinese qualifier presentation of round 3. This is New Element versus CNB. Here we are making our way to round 3. It was a little bit delayed from some scheduling conflicts coming through from the side of the Chinese, but we make it through nevertheless, and it should be a very interesting game. Now, should preface this with the fact that New Element has been playing out of their minds and extensively throughout the early stages of the tournament here. They just got out of like an almost 70-minute long game up against Dreamtime, where they upset them, which is pretty awesome. And prior to that, they actually faced off against CIS for a full 117 minutes. So, very little rest for these guys, some substantial mental fortitude. We'll see if they can hold it here. They only got about 5 minutes break, and then obviously they'll rest up a little bit through the draft, and they'll take it from here. CNB, they've gotten a lot of time to kind of hang out here. The entire duration of that 67 or so minute match, they were just chilling out in the lobby, so I think they're ready to rumble. Anyways, thank you guys so much for tuning in to join Dota community here for the EU Hub presentation of this match. I'm myself in Blaze, and today I'm joined by Whiplash.
Hello, Blaze. Can you hear me? Everything all good from my end?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome, man. Good to hear. I don't have too much experience with the Chinese scene, but I do pop in every now and then, and I'm really excited to cast some of the TI qualifier games. Thanks a lot, for Blaze, of course, for inviting me along. And I did pop into a few of the matches, the last two, and yeah, they're pretty long. That's all I really have to say about them.
I don't know, man. New Element really impressed me. Like, the way they were playing, the way that they were controlling global presence, specifically the one time where Nature's Prophet opted to rat instead of force a fight at Roche, forcing opponents back so that they could subsequently take Roche, and that objective-based mindset. It reminded me of Alliance this time 1 year ago, where they were just so active about using buybacks at the right time, controlling positioning on the map, and just having a great sense of the game as a whole. So I really feel that's what gave them the upper hand in that matchup in the previous game. I didn't get a chance to, unfortunately, watch the big one against CIS, but obviously Black Dota prevails with his carrying. In this case here, though, they obviously are showing to be a team with great amounts of potential, and we'll have to see exactly what they have in store. An interesting draft already starting off from both sides, though. I mean, Ancient Apparition Rubick picking up both supports in the first place is a little bit weird, but the reason the Rubick is so prioritized here is look what they're up against. Brewmaster Treant, what better ultimates to steal? So it is very unorthodox to see these four come into play, but you can kind of understand the reasoning behind all four picks.
Yeah, definitely. I do like the Rubick as well. Beyond the ultimates, you can still steal if you manage to somehow grab Living Armor. Well, that's just a great spell to have. My favorite spell for sure on Treant Protector. And so far, the bans have just been, you know, pretty standard. Batrider, Invoker, and then we have Lycan, Centaur, and then Dazzle. A TA getting banned out as well. A little bit less common, but still certainly a hero that can warrant a ban against teams that you know like the run that hero. And I guess that'd be pretty solid in their lineup as well. We also have Wraith King being banned out from New Element, so that would actually make CNB's lineup pretty darn tanky if you look at that. If they added the Wraith King into the mix along with a Treant Protector and then a Brewmaster who can simply, you know, split whenever, you know, he starts getting focused down.
Yeah, that would be very difficult if they had to kind of punch through all that damage. Along with that, he's just a hero with that extra second life. It means that the Ice Blast of Ancient Apparition isn't as relevant, even if he does get his Aghanim Scepter. He's always come back with full life and without having to worry about that ultimate until it comes off CD. But in turn, yeah, we see CNB banning out the kind of rather glass cannon-y type heroes on the mid lane that Brewmaster might have trouble dealing with. Now, I will say that if you go for an early point in Drunken Haze, you can manage yourself against a Templar Assassin pretty well. But as far as forcing her back, getting kills on her, easier said than done when you consider that refraction against him. So, as a whole, I think that they're really trying to set up Brewmaster for success. They obviously prioritized it for one of their first two picks, and they need to give him some space to get going, because in the right hands, those Brew Links, that ultimate, so darn powerful, and maybe Rubick will get the opportunity to show exactly what can be done with it as well, but for the most part, we're looking for that Brew, going for the Blink into Aghanims, and really just controlling the fight from there. Subsequently, they're taking their third pick here. The Venomancer is going to be the pickup for them. One that I didn't suspect at all, but when it comes down to it, if you find somebody off the tower and you get a Gale on them with a Latrine Protector with his massive right-click damage right nearby, it's going to be very difficult to actually get away. The Leech Seed, the Gale, they'll lock you down, and from there the physical and magical damage will take its toll.
Yes, certainly it could be a very powerful combination in the laning stage early on. But the one thing that CNB, I feel, really lacks right now is not slow, because, well, they got a ton of slow. They don't really have any straight-up disables. The same can kind of be said for New Element as well. They just have the telekinesis from Rubick. But still, though, I mean, Doom obviously provides a lot with his ultimate against Brewmaster especially. I feel he's a hero that just is going to not be happy if he has the Doom on him. So, you know, they're bringing in a lot of powerful heroes, I think, they'll be good for picking off, but laning stage, I'm really liking CNB so far. Whoa, hold on. They just picked up a Bloodseeker. Does this mean we're seeing Panda in the off lane, or what's going on here, man? Do you have any idea, Blaze?
I mean, the Bloodseeker can lane wherever the heck he feels like, to be honest. If he's in a 1 position, if he's in a 2 position, he's still going to be able to sustain pretty well with that thirst, or actually, sorry, with the Bloodbath. But I guess it's just going to be about the fact that they can significantly enable him with the Venomancer's ultimate. You throw down the Poison Nova, everybody's going to be dropping below 50% HP, and that's where Bloodseeker gets completely out of control, where he can just dash through the fights. Like, you take one second of running through a fight and Cold's Feet is broken. The telekinesis is going to be difficult to... It'd just be the only cooldown that currently holds him in place. And yeah, he can just stay on target, right-click on these low-armor heroes, and cause a huge amount of problems. Now, as far as I know, Bloodseeker is also not really disabled very much by Doom. As he silences himself very frequently in the fights, he doesn't really worry about a silencing effect, and I don't think it takes out either Bloodbath or Thirst. So in that case, Bloodseeker is just going to be a very active hero that can deal with that Doom very effectively. So it's gank-oriented, it's very aggro, and CMB look to close this out quick.
Yeah, that's true. This is really cool. I can't wait to see how they play this. Definitely going to be a lot of ganking, a lot of aggression in the early stages. Just based on their lineup alone, it screams aggression, it screams in your face and wanting the you know, really just forcing a lot of fights. New Element, I noticed they have Ancient Apparition and Rubick, so I'm thinking maybe they could try to pick up a Weaver and do some type of offensive try kind of situation, which would be very powerful. They'd have a pretty good punch, but the Treant Protector would help out somewhat against that with the Leech Seed and Living Armor. And New Element, they decide to pick up the Puck. Do you think this is going to be in the offlane, or is it going to end up mid and we're going to see that Doom in the position one? What do you kind of see happening here?
More and more we've been seeing Puck transition into the offlane, and it would be the hero that can survive against Venomous Gale off tower. Like, otherwise, any hero that doesn't have a blink, or in this case a jaunt, to get out of there is going to have a lot of issues, including the Doom. But I still kind of prefer the Puck in the mid roll. I think you can control CS better with his Illusory Orb up against the Bloodseeker, and then do more if he gets a gank by his allies. Rubick rotates in, maybe AA. The Puck can generally get better control over that situation. But all in all, I think they could run it either way. I think that's the strength of the draft right now, is the flexibility arrangement they have going on. But I still keep on looking at this Bloodseeker pick, and I think that it actually is going to do a lot of work here. Like, I looked it up, Doom does disable the Bloodbath, but you're going to not really receive the healing from your last hits when you're going to be hit by the Ice Blast anyway, so that's not really an issue. And when you look at the supports, the bane of Bloodseeker's existence is defensive support. Somebody gets defensively disrupted, somebody gets healed half their health, Shallow Grave, so on and so forth. But Rubick and AA don't bring any of that. So we'll have to see how the lanes play out, but for now, there's going to be a hell of a lot of damage flying about, and I really do think CMB can just start snowballing out of control.
Yeah, this is really cool, and they round things up with a Timber Saw, which is a great mid-game hero, just providing even more burst to their team. So yeah, this is basically just going to be an action-packed game from them. They can't really sit back and farm because they don't have an insane amount of late-game presence compared to New Element, who they have the Doom, which I feel does scale better than the Brew, Bloodseeker, and the Timber Saw in the later stages. They have the Puck, which is, I guess, somewhat equivalent to like the Timber Saw. I want to see what their last pickup is, because this will kind of determine exactly what they want to do with their lane. So are they going to put that puck in the off lane? Is Doom going to end up in the safe lane? You know, how are they finishing off things? And with the last bans being the Lifestealer and the Nature's Prophet, it looks like CNB is anticipating some type of carry out from New Element.
Yeah, I mean, it's got to be something along those lines. I don't know if the Bloodseeker would have, or the Lifestealer would have been that problematic against them, because they still have the Overgrowth and so on and so forth, but the Rage is really good against Brewmaster's Ultimate and Timbersaw as well, so they do want to worry about Magic Immunity. They take that off the field, and instead, Faceless Void will appear. So the Chronosphere, the Dream Coil, both great setups for the Ice Blast, but that assumes that Ancient Air Person is going to have level 6, and let's just see how aggressive this CMB lineup can actually get.
I really like the Void pickup. If you look at CNB's lineup, they have 4 melee heroes. It's going to be so easy to get like some nice clutch Chronospheres when you get in the thick of fights and with CNB wanting to be so aggressive. So I think this could actually work pretty well for them, but it's that you have to kind of survive the early stages of the game. You have to get a little bit of farm in the Void, and as long as they can do that, I think they'll be okay. But CNB, definitely, they're going to have the aggression from the start, and that will be the biggest concern for any.
Yeah. So, looking over at the two sides here, I guess we'll go ahead and look at New Element to start. Thank you guys so much for tuning in here to join Dota Community for the European Hub presentation of New Element versus CNB. Starting from left to right, we're going to be looking over at Shiki here on the puck. Going to be running the Fairy Dragon in the mid lane with just one Tango pooled, starting off with that Null Talisman. Looking over at the support, Rubik, this is the answer. Playing here in the number 5 role, I believe. And then, yeah, of course, we do have Maples alongside him. Going to be playing the number 4 Ancient Apparition. So this is going to leave the offlane Doom to go boots first and actually go 1 versus 1 against the Timbersaw, which I feel favors Timbersaw just a little bit because of the Whirling Death against a high-strength hero. But finally, we get to look down at bottom, and that is going to be DJ, I suppose, on the Faceless Void.
Yeah, if we go ahead and bring it over to CNB's court, CNB China, we have the Treant Protector, played by 888, over to the mid, or not mid, the offlane, I guess offensive offlane or offensive tri-lane player. It's stand-in SDN as the Brewmaster. Moving over to the top, it's the Timbersaw 8, KKKK. These guys have some interesting names, I have to say. And then in the mid lane, it will be the Bloodseeker, another stand-in actually, and his name is Dogfights. Finally, we have Venomancer, 5,400, and he'll be in that bottom offensive tri-lane.
Now, I will note that for the most part, when you see stand-in, it's actually a bug as far as how the new Steam ID tags are working with regards to the teams. The rosters are kind of set.
Hold on a second, bottom lane. Wow. There's already a huge exchange, two members dead. But the Treant Protector, you get the first blood before dying. Faces Void down to low health already. And, wow, okay. Sorry, what were you saying about the stand-ins? We had too much action early on.
Well, with the International 4 qualifiers, the rosters are essentially set in stone when the invites go out. So there are not going to be any stand-ins for this tournament. And anytime you see that tag, it's going to be just a bug as far as how the Steam ID collaborates with their team ID. So it's just they're all definitely permanent members of the roster, at least as Valve sees it anyways, and yeah, we'll see them playing kind of at full strength, and a lot of strength coming down bottom. My goodness, is this an aggressive lane? Gale will come out on Rubik, but I don't think they want to go that deep, do they? Wow. Oh. Going down under the tower.
But it just gets turned around on them. Once again, it's a support for support trade. These guys are absolutely fearless. So I guess they really want to take advantage of this tri-lane in the early stages, but I mean, at the end of the day, they're still feeding kills, or at least extra experience, to this Void, and I mean, in the long run, it'll definitely benefit him, so that's a bit of a concern, but still, they're causing some chaos, and I do like that.
Yeah, I think they're afraid of how strong New Element is as a team when they go to the late game. I mean, you're up against a Doom, Faceless Void, and Ancient Apparition, all great heroes towards the late game, and they know that, obviously, that's New Element's strength. They've seen the last two games. So they kind of made a game plan that doesn't allow that to happen. Now we do see the Leech Seed coming out after the Gale. The Time Walk is not enough. Faceless Void is going down. The last right click, though, so many backtracks, but in the end, Treant will grab that up for himself.
And it seems like Rubik, he doesn't even have a second to stay away from this lane, or Faceless Void's just toast, as we saw, and I mean, it doesn't matter, I guess, that they don't have any actual real stuns. They just have an insane amount of slows, and that's all they really need to secure kills. But maybe a little bit of a turnaround. There's a, I guess, not a backtrack, but a time walk onto the Venomancer, and they get an easy kill there. There may be a turnaround onto the Ancient Apparition. He's doing his best to get away. There's a little bit of body blocking, but it's not enough, and they may actually get a turn kill on the Treant Protector. So, Faceless Void, he just nabbed himself a double kill.
Yeah, that's a very costly non-committal. They go ahead and get initiated on. They could leave the Venomancer high and dry, but instead, they not only don't get a kill, but they feed the Treant Protector on top of that. So he's sitting at only level 3, currently sitting 0, 1, and 2 in his skill build. So they will be able to persist through some damage instances, but like Chilling Touch is its own damage instance. So even though it is mostly nullified by the Living Armor block, it at least takes up a charge. And from there, as soon as the charges are gone, you can be doing full damage to your opponent. So yeah, it's going to be a little bit frustrating for them to try to rely on this Living Armor just to fight it out when Venomancer himself doesn't add that much damage to these clashes.
Faceless Void was forced back for the time being. He'll be returning to the bottom lane, however. And we've been really talking a lot about this bottom lane, and there may be a little bit more action coming at any point, but I just wanted to pop in quickly, check out these other lanes, like between Bloodseeker and, of course, the Puck. It looks like somewhat even, I guess, Bloodseeker with a bit of an edge over that Puck. He just has so much sustainability with that Bloodbath.
And, oh, they're going in again, bottom.
Oh. All right, I guess the action's happening once again. They're trying to slow down Treant Protector, but he gets out just in time. There's a Thunderclap, but Faceless Void is already looking pretty darn tanky. He time walks forward, and another hit or two. They may be able to kill. Yes, they do get it. So the Venomancer falls, and I think, Blaze, at this point, the offensive tri-lane from CNB just isn't working out.
Yeah, it's essentially failed. I mean, yeah, they got the early kills and forced Void to fight rather than farm, but that's not going to be a problem for him if he's able to farm heroes. So he's sitting at 2-1-2. He's actually at the top of the net worth charts, despite what pressure they've been trying to put out on him. And who are they really getting the benefit of for farm down on bottom lane? The Brewmaster, sitting at only 1600 net worth. He's not going to be having that blink for quite some time. And yeah, they're just going to continue to feed kills if they keep on trying like this. Like, they have a window of opportunity to put some hits into Faceless Void, but as soon as Ancient Apparition gets some mana up again, that Chilling Touch is just too much for them to deal with. And now Puck can rotate. He's got his Dream Coil. No TP scroll at the moment, but controlling the mid lane pretty effectively.
Indeed. And really, the only lane that I noticed CNB actually are doing decent in is, like, I guess, more than decent is top lane. The Timbersaw's getting a lot more right clicks and last hits over Doom, but really, I mean, it's a Doom. He just maxes out Devour and he'll eventually catch up anyway. So it's not the end of the world if he's behind in CS against the Timbersaw. So I don't know. I don't feel like that's enough for CNB. They need to have a really strong presence in this mid game, and losing this tri-lane versus tri-lane war, the Faceless Void's just going to have a ball, and you know, he'll be in a great position when it comes to mid game.
Yeah. Doom isn't in a happy spot right now. He was forced to go into Tranquil Boots. He's going to cover up the top rune if it does indeed spawn there. But otherwise, like you said, he's just going to be able to rubber band no problem at all. And it's going to be on Timbersaw to take that farm advantage and make some use of it. He's done great in CS, but if he's just sitting on top lane, then there's nothing going to happen. Bloodseeker pops a rupture but gets doomed up. There is the Dream Coil locking him in place. He will not get the heal from Bloodbath. Waits for the tether to expire and actually just buys. I guess just because the damage over time effect was too much and there was nobody TPing him for the deny. So, yeah, he's going to pick up his phase boots, gets a solo kill essentially on the Puck, and Doom committing his ultimate while Timber farms top.
Indeed, so... Oh, bottom lane, we have more action going on once again. They get Venomancer for, I think, like the fourth time actually. They're trying the Cold Feet Brewmaster. He's able to just scurry out of there thanks to his boots of speed. And Timbersaw has joined the fight as well. They may actually get a kill. No, the Timber Chain.
Wow.
And misses on Faceless Void. He's salving up really quickly as well. He's buying a little bit of time, but it's simply not enough. The Time Walk was on cooldown. In came Timbersaw with the burst. So they secure a kill, and they may get another one on Puck as well. He's silenced up. Down he goes. It's a two, and there may be a third one following that up as well. The chain misses, but everybody just piles in onto Rubik. And down he falls. So
and this is exactly what they need to do. This is how you play this lineup, is say, okay, Ancient Apparition doesn't have six. Dive, dive, dive. Just submerge the submarine, go as deep as possible, and get these kills. Because they do have a lot of beefy heroes that can tank up the tower, no problem at all. And yeah, they have a lot of chase potential as well. Now, one of these heroes has a hard time closing the distance between their opponents if they have a stable mana pool. So I'm thinking they need maybe one more arcane boots, but otherwise push down the towers, get the kills, and keep this gank train rolling.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Like, when you see this group, like when they're grouped up as five at this early in the game, it's like, what can any really do to stop them? It just seems like it's a really hard and difficult thing to fight against. And, you know, behind the tower kill and the good engagement, Brewmaster picks up his Blink Dagger. So things were not looking so good for CNB, but it only took one team fight in a tower to completely turn things around. And they're actually ahead as far as experience and gold is concerned.
Hasted Bloodseeker, gotta always watch out for that. But at least for the moment, the big thing that New Element can take solace in is they have the late game absolutely secured. There is no way that if, like, 35, 40 minutes into the game, CNB hasn't broken racks, that New Element doesn't actually win this one. We do see Sheiki using the TV scroll, wisely just making sure he doesn't have to worry about anything. He didn't actually get afflicted by Rupture, but it's still just always have that TP scroll available, and there's very little they can do to stop it. In fact, if we look at their skills, if Brewmaster's pandas aren't up, the only thing that actually stuns on this team is the overgrowth from tree, and he's only just now about to have that available at level 6.
Huh. So do you think this Faceless Void or the Doom will really be prioritizing a BKB in this game? I guess they still have a lot of damage to worry about, but do you think due to the lack of stuns it may be an item they can easily forego?
I don't think they can ignore it. There's just a lot of magic damage flying out from all sides. I mean, the Fire Panda does a decent amount. The Venomancer, of course, with the ultimate will be doing a huge amount. But it's really hard to build in this situation. Like, I kind of feel Manta it would help a lot. BKB would help a lot. Hell, Blade Mail would do some work on some of these heroes. But it just comes down to the fact that they need a lot of things at once. We're going to see Dream Coil plus TK expended on the Brewmaster, and with this Doom, they will be able to secure that kill. He does spend his unreliable gold before falling, but otherwise a pretty easy pick for New Element. Now, I think the big deal is getting the blink on Puck, and then just them playing responsively. Like, they got the mechanism on Doom, that's pretty huge. And from there, I don't think they necessarily need gold as much as they need levels.
Indeed, Rubik's still waiting for that level 6. Meanwhile, bottom lane, though, we have Brewmaster getting very aggressive. He's gonna get hit a few times, and looks like he overstayed his welcome. Faceless Void on the Ancient Apparition were able to get a kill, and top lane, oh, Bloodseeker as well was low on health. He's able to teleport out safely before dying. So, A-OK there, but not for the Timber Saw.
Yeah, it's just about persisting through the fights as much as possible. Like, hell, I'd say a Vladimir's Offering wouldn't be a bad pickup, just to deal with some of this damage, mitigate it, and survive. The longer anybody survives a New Element, the less opportunity the Bloodseeker has to continuously feast off of that blood path, as well as just continuously gain momentum in throughout the fight. So I would have to say survival is key. Anything defensive will be okay, because the natural offensive capabilities of their heroes will suffice.
Yeah, and speaking of survivability items, Doom recently picked up his mechanism, so that'll certainly help them all out a lot in terms of team fighting. And we have a smoke from both the Doom and the Rubik. They're fishing, they're looking for somebody to kill. They're heading to the mid lane, and Bloodseeker looks like he'll be the target. He's getting telekinesis up in the air. He gets an ability stolen, actually his own silence, the Blood Rage, finishes the job, and just easy, clean, quick kill for NE. But CNB will be pushing this tower on the top lane, and I don't think anything can save that.
Yeah, and these towers are really important for CNB to pick up now, because first of all, we've already mentioned that they need to end the game relatively early. Second of all is that they don't have much push going for them right now. They have Plague Wards, and that's about it. They otherwise don't have any major push mechanic, and they're going to have to just, you know, brute force it. Throw a few punches, and that's going to be all they can really accomplish. But blink again. Oh, a great silence from Rubik. That would have been devastating if they got the slow off.
The Blood Rage is just... it's actually a really nice spell to steal. We don't see it too often, but hey, it's just an extra silence on the Rubik. It's got a decent cast range, actually, so they're able to kind of hold CNB off for the time being. But we did see Faceless Void. He just picked up his Hand of Midas, and with the way that CNB is being aggressive this game, do you think it's the right choice to grab that, or should he have gone for an item that'll help him out more in earlier fights?
I mean, you can't just go raw rush like an Aghanim Scepter or something like that. It's not going to really work for you. So I think the Midas is a good build-up item. Like I said, they need experience as much as they need gold. Now we're going to see a big Chrono comes through and a great Ice Blast too.
Oh, look at the combination. They get basically everything. There's an Overgrowth to kind of keep any in place as well, but then a follow-up Dream Coil onto the Venno, onto Dream Protector. They're trying to get out of there. Healed up a little bit more, but there's too much DPS coming in from NE. Timbersaw, it looks like he will TP out, but everybody else is dead, and, well, this is just starting to look very, very bad for CNB.
Losing a ton of momentum there. We're going to see a 4,000 experience advantage coming out for new element, and this is on the back of a Midas. Like I said, he's not going to be like raw right-clicking these guys down. That's piddly damage compared to their team fight from just Ancient Apparition's ultimate, Pux as well. His combo was absolutely perfect there without the blink, and it just comes down to them underrating the Chronosphere. He rotates, he kills, and they gain full control of this game. Just need a couple good wards up, and they'll be back in business.
Yeah, it comes down to what I was talking about earlier, Blaze, where, I mean, CNB, they have four melee heroes. It's hard to not get a good Chronosphere off at this point. And it's what we saw in the last battle, and, I mean, if that just keeps happening, I don't really know what else CNB can do. Doom's picked up a Midas as well. I guess they're very happy with how things are going, and they're just okay dragging it on into the later stages. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's just all about defensive play at this point. As long as they control their towers, they're going to be perfectly fine here. And Faceless Void, that change to Chronosphere really helps him out. The fact that it is a shorter cooldown, and that, of course, he has more mana to spam out with the Time Walk shorter, a lower mana cost. So in this position, he has Chronosphere coming up in 20 seconds, so they can do it again. If CNB keep trying to force this, then they're going to be able to make them pay. So in this position, maybe CNB smokes Roche. Maybe they find a pickoff with some kind of subterfuge, but it's always new element that's on the aggression. Like right here, coming through, Brewmaster pops his ultimate in time, which is very good, but he's got to make sure at least one panda gets out quick.
And look at this, NE, they're totally okay with not overextending. They just back up, they say, okay, you did the primal split, that's fine. We'll come in and fight afterwards. Also, notice Timbersaw being very aggressive in the enemy jungle. He is close to being surrounded at all times, but as I say that, the Puck is the one that gets surrounded. In comes the Chronosphere. He can't save his allies, but still, three have been stuck in there. Remember, Primal Split is down. There's the Doom on Timbersaw. We'll see if he can get out of there, but I think he's okay. He's just really darn tanky. And a new element. They're looking for Bloodseeker. He's dodging a little bit in the trees, still very high in health. He'll get lifted up, though, and a Stomp Stone from the Rubick. A little bit of right click, some spell damage. They get the kill on him, but Timbersaw's coming back. It looks like he does not want to end this fight. And this could be a mistake for him that could ultimately cost his life if he doesn't get out of there fast enough. There's now a silence onto Brewmaster. He's doing his best, the best to get out of there, but the time walk slowing him down a little bit. Still, though, he's A-okay. Overgrowth to keep people in place. Ancient Apparition low on health. He's going to go down. Same with the Timbersaw, though. So, one for one trade there. Definitely okay. From new elements and Dream Protector, he's just a little bit too tanky, so they back off.
Man, this Rubick use of the Blood Rage was really good there. The Timbersaw had a decent mana pool going for him, but used the Blood Rage right when he had used his ultimate. So the Chakram is stuck out for the full duration of the silence, and the bonus attack damage doesn't matter because while Timbersaw's ultimate is active, he can't actually attack. So it's the perfect counter to him in this situation, and that steal becoming more and more relevant. They did take a lot of damage on their top tier 2, drops down to 250 HP, but the Doom rotation was enough to scare Venomancer Dyer's back. So, all in all, attack. Not too shabby for a new element. They hold the line. I mean, it's not a clear-cut victory in either case, but it's perfectly fine for them. They're going to be able to hold it. They're going to be able to push the game later and later, and we do see that Void now working towards that Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah, I love the new Aghanim Scepter. Well, not new, just I love Aghanims in general. Void makes them able to have that Dyer's Chrono up pretty much every team attack. Fight, and with the way CNB are playing, that's I feel like it's the best item choice. And I've noticed that CNB have warded up the Ancient Creep Camp, and I think a new element know about that. Well, hold on a second, we have a Chrono in the top lane. It's on Timbersaw. We'll get hit a little bit from the Rubick, from the Fade Bolt, lifted up in the air, and down he goes into the grave.
It's so hard once ultimates are available for CNB to feel confident in any position here. It's just that you look at every single ultimate from new element, and each one of them is extremely potent in all stages of the game. I mean, obviously the puck falls off when you get BKBs, but who's really going to buy a BKB on the side of CNB? Like, maybe the Bloodseeker, maybe the Brewmaster, but not for a while.
Well, check out Tramp Protector. He got silenced up. The rest of New Element are coming in as well. There's Eurogrowth blocking people in place, and then a it's not a Blood Rage, but a Rupture on the puck. It's enough. They get the DPS to finish him off. Now faces Void. He's backing up. A few people are frozen on CNB's end. We'll see if they can shatter. Void wants to finish off the tree. Another hit should do the job, and he does get it. But here comes Panda. He's able to accomplish a lot. Venomancer, low on health. He's down, but throws out his ultimate just before that happens. And Ancient Apparition stunned up by the three pandas. We'll see if they can finish him off. Meanwhile, elsewhere, a few Cyclones. Timbersaw is moving in and seeing what damage he can do. They've gotten the puck, they've gotten the Ancient Apparition, and everybody else may get it out of their Rubik escapes just in time. Multiple TPs away from New Element, and it's just, it's kind of back and forth between them. No clear-cut victor in that engagement.
I don't know, TP Skrull OP, man. Like, they can disengage at any point in time. They made kind of a mistake for going that deep in the first place because they didn't have the Chrono, and the Doom went out on the Venomancer, which it did stop his mechanism from coming out until the Ice Blast had already been put on, like, three different heroes. So that's, I mean, it definitely helped them win the take what wins they could get out of that fight. But even still. It's just like, it was a little bit of overextension just going for that attempt on Treant, who is surprisingly tanky with Urn of Shadows here. He's got over 1200 HP. He's not an easy pick by any standard, and the Void obviously still doesn't have the right-click damage to back everything up. So maybe, I kind of feel like they should just tone it down a little bit here. They can keep farming and progress towards that mid-game dominance, but for now, taking even exchanges are perfectly fine, and they will actually put some pressure out here on the mid lane.
Indeed they will. I think it's about time for New Element to grab a tower, but we still have, they have to worry about the living armor, so they'll certainly have to commit if they want to get a tower, and multiple people coming in from CNB, they want to defend this. There's Leech Seed on the Doom, he's ruptured as well, but nice Chronosphere, blocking multiple people into place, and there's your Ice Blast as well. Down go both of the supports from CNB. We'll see who they can get next. That's the question, and it looks like Rupture was stolen on the Brewmaster. He's faded, bolted into death. He also gets Timbersaw on the back of that. It's an entire team wipe.
Wow.
I just think CNB, they don't have any answer for New Element's lineup, and it's only going to get worse.
Yeah, you get Doom, Ruptured, and Dream Coiled, and you're like, okay, what do I do now? Like, you're in this crazy situation where there's absolutely no answer, and whatever items you have don't mean a single thing. So now we do see that they are losing huge amounts of momentum. They lost their tier 2. Top will take some hits, but I think they'll just be denied by the Face of Void here. And yeah, now look at the warding situation. Before, it was Dire controlling the jungle. It was Dire warding all over the Radiant side, and now we see the exact opposite. They've been banking wards for a while. They dropped one in mid, they dropped one towards the Secret Shop, and a couple others by their Ancients and by their mid lane. So they really are just keeping tabs on exactly where CNB are moving. And the reason is because CNB have no other choice but to just run down mid and try to take this tier 1. They need to end this game soon, and they haven't even actually dropped down that first tower there. So that's going to be the starting point for them, and New Element seem prepared.
Yeah. Ooh. And Timbersaw, actually, he dies to Rubik. I think Ancient Apparition may have helped out a little bit with that. I only caught the tail end of the fight, but surprising to see a Timbersaw die when there's just a Rubik in the vicinity. I have to say, this Rubik's been doing absolute work, stealing a lot of very valuable spells throughout the game and making these team fights work a lot better for New Element.
Yeah, this Rubik is, I honestly use the spells of the enemy better than the enemy is using it themselves. So, I mean, in that position, it's hard to feel confident in it. I mean, you understand why they first picked that Rubik, or phase one picked that Rubik at least, is because he's using it so effectively. You can steal the split, you can steal either of Bloodseeker's spells, and in this case, obviously, they just stole Timbersaw's Willing Death, which works well against a 43 strength hero. Now Puck blinking in, very dangerous position, and gets a great silence, a great Dream Coil, and will jaunt away! Holy crap! Are they just gonna let him do that?
Yeah, I guess so. They even get hit with an Ice Blast from halfway across the map. So they're forced back, and on the tail end, I believe top lane, Faceless Void got a kill on the Timbersaw once again.
Yeah, Chrono's
this guy has died a lot.
Yep, well, I mean, you get that short cooldown on the Aghanim Scepter. He can just Chrono for every kill he sees. Taking a free Timber, taking a free tower, and continue pushing in, perhaps. No, we actually see Doom in a weird spot here. He gets Overgrowth and Ruptured with his BKB up. Bloodseeker going to be able to walk out of here with a little bit of help from his allies, unless the Ancient Apparition ulti comes through. Obviously, that changes things for the finishing blow, but it looks like it's not coming, and of course there's the mech. Oh, there's the Ice Blast! Not going to hit him. And,
really close. Tower
is
under attack.
AA is level 11. I think that actually might have done the trick, but the world may never...
Yeah, I guess the world will never know, unless somebody really wants to do the math, but let's not worry about that. Now, I guess this Void, he already has 3,400 gold, and he's completed his Aghanim Scepter, so is he looking for a Mjolnir or something? What's his next item? Well, regardless of that, he's moving in once again on the Timber Saw. There's some Drunken Haze that kind of prevent him from really doing a lot of damage, and Tran Protector just caught in the middle of things. He just got blown up very fast. There's a nice Thunderclap from the Panda, but he has to back up. His ultimate's on cooldown. More deaths on the side of CNB, but NE also losing a lot of members as well. It's a 3-4-2 trade. They get the tower, but still, we're seeing CNB show a few signs of life.
It's a little weird when you see the Timbersaw, who's fed a couple of kills, get an unstoppable streak off of the support Rubick, but that's kind of what just happened. So they get a killing spree off Ancient Apparition, they get an unstoppable streak off of Rubick, and they do rebound quite a bit as far as gold goes, so that will help out a lot. Obviously, the problem was they didn't have the Doom there. He just got picked off in the mid, and then the Chronosphere was still unavailable. So that all in all, questionable movement from New Element, but I don't know if it cost them that dearly. Now Faces Void has picked up his BKB. He won't have to worry about the Drunken Haze, and if he times it well, not even the Overgrowth. So it just really comes down to timing, usage, etc. But Faces Void in a decent position here. Like, yes, the Blood Rage Silence persists for BKB, and we did see it cast on him last time around, but in that case, if you're immune to magic damage and you're having your auto attack damage amplified by 120% base, just go ahead and right click the hell out of people and the Ice Blast will do the rest.
Yeah, it's not like Faceless Void even is too concerned about picking up damage items. You just wanted to get the utility, the survivability first. Like you said, Blaze, Ice Blast helps out so much. There's a lot of other AoE like Puck helping out. So really, he just goes in there and kind of locks people into place, and he's golden. And just later on is really when he'll get his damage online, and just he becomes a scarier hard carry on NE's end. Really, man, it's not looking too good for CNB. Regardless of that last fight, I still feel like things are not too amazing for them, considering that EXP and gold are still pretty darn significant. 15,000 and 10,000.
What is he doing here? He's gonna tomb on the Timber Saw, but that's not a kill you can easily claim. I guess it's a distraction play for Chronosphere to come out and bring down two. First the Bloodseeker, next the Venomancer, and Ice Blast to try to secure the Treant as well. And it looks like it might work after that Overgrowth. He time walks right in front of him, and that last swing will bring him low. So now, we do see the Brewmaster on the back end taking down the Rubick, but that's a Rubick kill. Yes, the Panda just finishes up his Aghanim Scepter, but taking a 1-for-3, losing towers, maybe losing Roche, this is just a bad position to be in.
Indeed, Panda blinks away. There are a few supports nearby to kind of potentially take him down, but he's A-okay. And yeah, kind of a bit of an awkward team fight, but still New Element definitely getting the better end of things. Chronosphere, man. Got Chronosphere. And now Faceless Void picking up a Demon Edge. So we'll just have a lot more DPS to work with. Maybe you go into an early Monkey King bar to kind of deal with the Drunken Brawler if he really just dislikes Brewmaster.
Yeah.
But if not, you can get his Daedalus as well, I suppose.
I think MKB is most pertinent. You won't always have Chronosphere for that Brewmaster, so you won't be able to silence the... And same thing with the BKB for the Drunken Haze. So better safe than sorry, just to always have the ability to strike 100% hit rate. Now we see a solo kill attempt, and it is going to be a kill on the Treant, but Mechanism comes in, and he might be in a bad spot. Hasted movement speed expires. He's going to have to BKB TP, but there's no TP. So he's got a time walk out. The Rupture dealing a lot of damage here. They have full vision of him, and that should be the kill.
Well, it should be, but man, this Faceless Void is surviving for a long time, maybe just long enough to have some support help him out. Still though, he's low on health and Bloodseeker will have the thirst on him. Timbersaw charging for it as well, and he'll get the kill. They also take out Rubick. So, yeah, not bad of a kill. I think Faceless Void just getting a little bit too cheeky there. Yeah, he has his Black King bar, but still, I mean, if everybody from CNB comes in, you're not going to win.
Yeah, I think when he chronoed the tree and he saw the two TBs, he should just walk away with that. I mean, this is a 60-second cooldown for two TBs. That's fine, but now mid.
There's the BKB on Doom. He's got a Doom off as well. AA Blast hits. That Bloodsticker, though, he's still doing A-OK. Timbersaw, the target, low on health. Frostbite, I don't think it'll finish him off. It's going to be close, though. And I think he should be A-OK. Still, though, kind of behind enemy lines. And there's also Rupture on Puck. Looks like it will indeed fall down. And a bit of a follow-up. Overgrowth from Champ Protector. They're trying to take out Doom. Doom doing his best to man mode Bloodseeker. And it may actually just end up working. He gets the kill all of a sudden. Back to half health from almost none. And they're turning on to Ancient Apparition, who's slowed. Thanks to Poison Sting. In comes Panda with the blank. Primal Split. They get yet another kill. Faces Void still on the sidelines for another second. He'll be A-OK. We'll see if he wants to come back into this fight. He does have Chronosphere ready. And the Primal Split will be on cooldown. Rubick on the high ground. They get the Tier 1 tower.
Middle tower has fallen.
Interesting, like CNB, they're showing signs of life, and that's just kind of surprising to see New Element fall apart like that in a fight when they were doing so good earlier on.
Yeah, that was, I mean, just in general, I think they don't have a grasp on the game as far as how close it actually is. Like, obviously they're in a commanding position. Obviously they're leading, and just by a war of attrition, they'll win this game. But mistakes like that can actually turn things on its head. They force the Panda buyback, they kill off the Bloodseeker, but they also committed, like, a 4v5 underneath their Tier 1 that they didn't even need. It seems like it was a overall poor decision, and if they don't contest this Roche, it's just going to be a freebie. The Drunken Haze, the Drunken Brawler, makes it so easy to take this without taking any damage, and they need a pretty big Ice Blast to scout it out.
Yeah, New Element, they don't even have any vision. They have, like, no wards on the map from what I can see, and I think they may not realize this, or they'll realize it too late. They seriously, I think they just don't know. They're going to smoke up, and I think they'll just find out too late. Roshan is about to fall. CNB looks to pick it up. They'll get it, and the Bloodseeker, he picks up the Aegis. So we'll see, though. There's initiation onto the Panda. He's doomed. This means no Primal Split. Stun as well for a little bit, so he goes down. The Venomancer falls as well under the Dream Coil. And there's a Rupture. And Overgrowth to stop the TP away. So we get the Ancient Apparition, but still, they take down
those
the
bashes.
Tree. And Bloodseeker, say goodbye to your Aegis. It's already gone. And I don't think he'll even escape out of this as well. They still have the Chronosphere available. They don't even need it. They'll use it, though, to get the Timbersaw. That's going to be a five-man wipe, boys. And look at that, CNB. Just call out the GG.
Yeah, very nicely done. Good steals from Rubick, taking Rupture once again. And the nail in the coffin was really killing off that Brewmaster with his buyback on cooldown. He had no way of coming back into the fight. Like you said, no Primal Split because of the Doom. And just based on that initiation alone, they pretty much secured that win. That Roche didn't make a difference. That Aegis couldn't make enough of an impact because New Element finally started fighting as five. The last, like, three fights leading up to that were three or four man Dota. But this time, they go as five. They get a nice, easy, clean win. And CNB know when they have been beat. 30 minutes into the game, we see a 39-22 kill score in favor of New Element. They take this game away here in round three of the International 4 Chinese qualifiers. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Hopefully you guys enjoyed these teams and this game here. Obviously, Bloodseeker, fun to watch, but unfortunately not as reliable when it comes down to contesting a lineup as strong as New Element. So I really am impressed by New Element. I think they have a lot of potential once they get the focus. When they say, okay, we're not going to take this casually, we just need to get our act together and focus for the kills. So they do really well here, and I'm expecting to see more from them in the near future, perhaps even making it through to the playoffs. CNB, 1 point down. They do need to really shape up their strategy if they're going to be able to progress. Anyways, once again, thank you guys for tuning in to join Dota community. Shout out to Monster Energy for presenting these regional qualifiers, as well as join Dota for giving us the opportunity to cast. And speaking of us, if you guys enjoyed the commentary, feel free to look us up, either providing constructive criticism for if you didn't enjoy the cast or what you liked about it. You can always look to follow us. We are over on twitter.com/blazecasting and twitter.com/yeahwhiplash. Anyways, thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll see you guys on the next one. Round 4 coming up in just a few minutes.